Hey everyone, I hope you're doing great. Welcome to Artichel's Art and welcome to this first episode of the brand new series on this channel. And in this series, we'll be painting three different beautiful meditating Buddhas. But in this episode right here, we will be watching the complete process of how I paint the first meditating Buddha of the series from start to finish. In all the three videos of the meditating Buddha painting series, there'll be a topic of discussion that we'll be talking about. So in this first video, we'll be talking about how to price your art, or how to price your paintings to be more specific. But before we get started with that, I just wanted to let you know that all the three meditating Buddha paintings are available for sale on my website www.artichels.com. And if you would like to learn how to paint these paintings from start to finish, then do check out the monthly art classes at www.artichelsartacademy.com, a place from where you can learn how to draw or paint by taking various classes or workshops. So all that being said, let's jump ahead and let's talk about how to price your artwork. So before I share with you how to price your artwork, I would like to share with you my story about how I got started with pricing my artwork. So you know, this was one of the most scariest things that I did when I was actually getting started with selling my works. So I first started making YouTube videos, and I used to share a lot of works of mine on Facebook as well. So my Facebook friends and, you know, people on my Facebook page, they started asking me that, you know, do you sell your works? Where do you sell your works? Let us know, we would love to buy. They started saying that. And I always used to tell them that I don't sell my works right now, but whenever I sell them, I will let you know. So I knew that, you know, people were interested in buying my work, but I was so scared of pricing my work. So even after telling people that yes, my works will be available soon on sale as well, I would just not put them on sale because, you know, of that fear of pricing my work in a wrong way, and that feeling that, you know, what if nobody buys my work after looking at the prices, or why will anybody pay for my work, you know, that negative kind of feeling surrounded me. So I never put my works on sale. So, you know, this feeling went on for a little more than one year, where I was too afraid to price my work, and even when people were asking, I was not offering anything at all. So, you know, one day I was contacted by a person who wanted to work with me on a commission basis. Like, he would help me with the sales and he would take a certain amount of commission with that and all that. So, you know, that person really pushed me to tell him the prices of my work so that, you know, he can go ahead and do something with it, or maybe make some sales or something like that. So, you know, at that moment, because that other person was literally sitting on my head to tell him the prices of my work, I finally built up some courage and I finally decided to price my artworks. And that was very difficult at that time because I was just starting out with selling my works at that time. You know, that process of initially pricing my artworks, even that took a lot of my time. Around 1 month it took out of me, you know, to take myself out of those negative feelings of self-sabotage, that who is going to buy my work, I mean, why will people pay for my work, and all that negative talks that I had in my mind. It took me around 1 month to just get out of it and price my works finally and give the prices to that person. So that is how I got started with pricing my works. Initially it was scary, but once I got started and once I started getting feedbacks and sales, and it increased my confidence, and once my online presence also started getting better, people were recognizing my work more, so I had the confidence from there to build up my prices little by little. So all this being said, without taking any more of your time, let's discuss about what are the points that I considered while pricing my artwork when I was starting out. But before that, a little disclaimer that I'm not an expert at pricing my artwork. I will only share the points with you that have helped me in my personal experience. And I really genuinely feel, and I really wish that, you know, these points will help you as well when you are starting out. or if you are a beginner at selling or pricing your artworks. Because, you know, I feel that beginning stage of pricing the artwork is one of the most scariest stage, according to me. And, you know, when we make some sales, when we have some experience, like for me right now that I have made enough sales and I have enough experience of selling artworks online, I am more confident about the prices of my artwork, because I know that the prices of my artwork are absolutely fair for the buyer as well as me, according to where I stand right now. So the first thing that I considered when I was starting out with pricing my artwork was the cost of my materials. Yes, the cost of the materials was the first thing that I took into consideration, because that had to come out. Because, you know, if I am lost with the cost of the material that I have used, then there's no point at all, you know. So, you know, first of all, I just considered and calculated all the cost of materials that went into that particular painting that I wanted to sell. So once I was done considering the cost of the materials I used in the painting, then I looked at, you know, what my standing was on the online world, you know, what level I was on. So for example, at that time I was already making YouTube videos, I had a Facebook page, so I looked at how much following I had over there, you know, and compared myself to the people with the similar kind of following. Over here we are talking about an online business. I'm not talking about selling my art through a gallery, because, you know, selling my art through a gallery or in person, that is a little different. Pricing that way, it's a little different, because when we are selling with galleries, a big chunk of commission goes to the gallery as well. So all that is considered while you are pricing when you're selling through a gallery. But over here I'm talking about selling your artwork through your online business. So, you know, I looked at where I stood in compared to how many followers I had, or you know, how many people cared about my art, or how many people were interested in my art. So then I found out people who were on the same level of online reach or following, or the same level or style of paintings. And you know, then I looked at how much those people charged their artwork according to the size and all that stuff. So, you know, that really helped me also to determine the prices of my artwork. But I did look at them, but I made sure that my artwork was on a lower side of the price end compared to them, even when we were in the same level of our online following. That was because, you know, when I was starting out, I was really scared that if anybody would buy my artwork or not. So, you know, that was just a testing period. That was just like putting my hand into a water and just checking is it hot or not. So, you know, that was the time I was just kind of playing around and looking what works. So I did put my price a little bit on the lower end compared to the artists I compared myself to. So that, you know, kind of really helped me get some initial sales. So, you know, when I look back now, those initial sales were not very fair on my part as an artist, but, you know, I really don't regret them at all, because, you know, those initial sales, even with the less amount of money, was a big confidence boost, and that actually got me started. And from then on, I little by little started to increase the prices of my work according to how much I was growing, you know, with my technical skills as well and with my online demand as well. And I'm really happy and confident with the price level of my artworks right now. So, you know, the third thing that I considered while pricing my artworks was the time I took to make those artworks. But I would tell you that I did not consider this a lot. Just, you know, a little bit of that thought I put in the time, because, you know, sometimes when we are not in the mood, the artworks tend to take more time to paint. Or, you know, sometimes because of some other reasons, the artwork tends to take some more time to paint, especially, you know, when we are a beginner artist, especially, you know, when we are still growing, our painting speed is also very slow. So that's why at that time when I was starting to sell my artworks, I did think about, you know, the time taken to paint those artworks, but I really did not calculate my price very much according to that. But right now, when I'm much ahead professionally compared to the time when I got started, right now I do consider the time taken as well, because even my speed has quite increased. Even my technical skills have quite increased compared to when I was getting started. So I do consider the time taken and how much do I need to charge for that as well compared to when I got started, because at that time this was a very small reason, or in fact this was not even a very serious reason to charge anybody, because you know my slow speed of painting was not anybody else's fault, you know. So I thought that it was unfair to charge for that, and I was not even confident about charging for that at that time. But you know, this is one more factor to take into consideration while pricing your artwork. And last but not the least, the thing that really matters to me and that still matters to me is that when I sell my artwork to somebody, I should, you know, not feel bad about overcharging or undercharging. You know, I should feel completely comfortable with the price that I have put on my painting. You know, I should not really undercharge, and I should not get that feeling that, oh my god, I am being exploited. That is a really not good feeling at all to get as an artist. And if I ever overcharge, I get that feeling of not being fair. So you know, we even have to go a lot with our instinct as well. You know, we even have to ask ourselves what we are comfortable charging, which is fair to us as an artist and fair to the buyer as well. So you know, listen to your gut, listen to your instinct, and do what feels absolutely right to you. So that is it. These were the points I considered while pricing my artworks initially when I was starting out, and these are the points that still help me out a lot as well. By the way, this question was asked by Honey Candy on my Instagram. So if you too have any question in your heart that you want me to talk about, then please feel free to let me know in the comment section below, or you can also follow me on Instagram, because you know I'm very active on Instagram. I share a lot of behind the scenes of these paintings on the Instagram. I share the process shots and much more over there. So for now, I would like to end the video right here. But before going, just a little reminder once again that if you would like to buy this work, then do check out www.artishells.com, which is my shop and blog. And if you would like to learn how to paint this painting, then do join in the monthly art classes at www.artishellsartacademy.com, a place from where you can learn how to draw or paint by taking various classes or workshops. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, and to support this channel, please share this video on your Facebook, or if you want, you can email it to someone you like. So I will see you on the second episode of this series, where I will come back with a new topic of discussion. Till then, bye and happy creating. Bye.